for the characters? Chiaki.
Our time for investigating is winding down.
So...
the bookshelf might take some time to investigate. We should try examining some other areas first.
The bookshelf?
There's a lot of books arranged here. Did Nagato bring these from the library?
Okay, now I'm a peeping Tom. Can you spot the peeping Tom? In addition to books, there's a bunch of random crap stuffed into the shelf.
It might take a lot of time for us to go thoroughly through, but that stuff...
Hey!
Let's just leave it for later. Yeah, I agree. I think that's the voice we gave him.
No!
Cyber Monokuma!
Hello, Monokuma. Didn't see him at first. I saw the sweat beads and I was like, oh, awkward.
There's a refrigerator.
Huh?
Nice. My cottage doesn't even have a refrigerator. I wonder where he got it from. Nagato probably supplied it himself. Why would he go to the trouble of putting a refrigerator in his room? Does he really enjoy cold drinks? To talk to Chiaki, I opened the refrigerator out of curiosity. There really isn't much inside except for Monokuma's special poison. For poison use only. Brown bottle. For someone who likes cold drinks, it doesn't look like he stocked very much. But...
whoa! Wait a minute. Hypothetical. Is this actual poison? Now, hang on. Poison for poison use only. Yes. Gotta be very thorough with the labels. There is a poison that can make you look like you're dead. But then the whole spear through the chest might like, that might be a moot point. Hang on. Well, wait, I see your thought process here, but the boy was stabbed through the chest repeatedly.
Yes, I forgot about that.
Well, it can put you in a almost death-like state. And it's still classified as a poison because if you don't pull somebody out of that or you don't take the right amount, then they will die. They'll go into a catatonic state and then they'll actually suffocate. But yeah, the spear might be a problem. That, yeah.
But that bottle clearly isn't a drink, right? Really? Looks like some kind of dietary supplement. Protein powder, maybe?
Or, you know, just read the label there, Hajime. I took the brown bottle out of the fridge and started reading the label. What's he made for?
Sending someone to death. Hey, this is...
could it be?
Yeah, looks like it's poison.
Poison?
Looks like there's a warning label on the back. Examine it in a little more detail. But careful with that bottle. Don't drop it. Or don't drink it, Hajime.
Why would I drink it?
I don't know. You do strike me as stupid. Stop it. If you order like that, I'm gonna get nervous.
Grabbed the bottle with a trembling hand and began reading the warning label on the back of the bottle. Poison made specifically for killing someone. It's Monokuma's special poison. This enchanted liquid is highly potent and takes effect immediately. Please handle with care. Though its volatility is low, that this liquid is very dangerous when vaporized?
Oh!
Mother! Wait! Was Nagato thinking of, like, trying to make it an aerosol version with the fire? And then kill everyone in the room and thus be safe, but then he got murdered because somebody found out? Like, crap. Okay, it's been a while since we actually picked up on this story. So it's been like at least 2 months, 3 months since we played this. At least a month. In gaseous state, it is heavier than air. It breaks down in minutes. And is susceptible to hydrolysis. So it is possible for you to poison someone to death without any complications. Keep
this liquid secure by storing it in a cool place, glass or glass container, away from sunlight. This sure does look like a chemical made solely for poisoning someone to death. Refrigerator must be here to keep the poison secure. But where did Nakito get something like this?
Well,
question could apply to the bomb he used as well too. Apply to the bomb?
See?
Could be a reason Nakito was able to obtain such dangerous items. The octagon inside the funhouse. This poison. He must have brought it with him from there too, right?
Perhaps.
Probably hiding it from somewhere on his body during the last class trial. He was hiding a bomb and poison during the class trial? Chris, what would he have done if he accidentally tripped and broke the bottle? Died, apparently. Just thinking about it, excuse me.
Hey, hey.
Also, he already blew up the bomb he took with him at the lobby. But what about this poison? Huh?
I like your hypotheticals, even though I will say nothing. Okay. I'm gonna throw things at the wall at this point because I have... I hit the wrong button. I'm trying to remember every little thing about this game. And Danganronpa is one of those games where you can't exactly like walk away sometimes.
It looks like the bottle is less than half empty. Was it like this from the beginning? Did Nakito use it?
All right, show of hands. Who's sipping poison?
If so, where did he? I wonder, is there still a trap somewhere that hasn't been sprung yet? Another trap?
Perhaps.
Simple. Maybe he was making some kind of trap using poison before he died. If that actually exists, real bad. It could potentially kill everyone on this island.
Or, how fast is the poison? Maybe Nagito is like,
I will be the best hope for everyone left alive. Because I found out that nobody's the traitor. So, because of this, and because of hope, and for hope's sake, winning out against all of darkness and evil, I will drink this poison, gash up my legs, and commit suicide.
For hope!
He's crazy enough to do it, let's be fair. Like, I don't typically think he did that, but if the game went that direction, I wouldn't write it off.
If that actually exists, it could be real bad. It could potentially kill everyone on this island. Everyone on the island? What the hell? Are you still trying to make us suffer? You still trying to make us suffer even after you died? You dick whistle.
Is that everything?
Time for investigating. He's winding down.
So.
Okay. Looks like there's still some things I need to investigate here. What button was the invest? Hang on. Ah, there we go. The bed. Was it slept in? It's the bed that comes with the cottage. It looks like it's just one of my other room, but.
Hey, hey.
Maybe there's something hidden under his bed? It's a useful place for hiding things.
Yeah, like thorn. Don't look at me! Alright. I had mine on mine. I was a smart boy. Crazy enough to do that. I will agree. Yes. Well, Nakito is, he's a special boy. He's
well, we should still check just in case.
No exceptions, and without thinking, I peeked under the bed and. Something here. Plastic bag from the supermarket. Ah! To grab gloves. It looks like there's something inside. Oh, he has gloves. Never mind. What is this?
It looks like a gas mask and rubber gloves. Look like the real deal. Did he get these from the military base? Gas bag. He was hiding these under his bed. What did Nakito use this stuff for?
And why would you have to hide it? I mean, unless whipping it out is more caustic than it should be.
Hajime.
Hajime, was there anything else under the bed?
See. He turned to the bed once again and started looking around the area where I found the supermarket back, and there's a small piece of paper on the floor. A piece of paper made of blue aluminium.
Round, thin piece of aluminium. Huh. It's similar to those seals that go over the cards of an open up mayonnaise. I get what you're saying, but does that mean it's just a piece of trash?
Wait. Time out.
It might be too soon to decide that. We don't have plastic aluminium like those over mayonnaise, so I've never like. Do we have anything like that? Maybe peanut butter jars. I could still be reading this, that self-insert Xtina hiding under the bed. Nagato's the boy that is in, that's totally into Elfin Lied. And thought that was like the best anime in the world. It's a good anime. It's just creepy. Basically, it's just like my cottage. Nothing about this window that really catches my eye. So... I is very thorough. Structure just like a room. The shower room is over here. Looks like there aren't any clues here. Okay. Fancy looking treasure box covered in sparkling pink lights. Apparently it was stolen from Monami's house. This is here. That means Nagato was the one who stole it from Monami. Why would Nagato steal this? Did he want the notebook that was inside? But Monami didn't write in that notebook, so who did? No, that notebook doesn't matter right now. Are we sure? A lot of books. Oh. The genres and the types of items are also random. Can't make any sense out of them whatsoever.
Well?
They say a shelf is a mirror that reflects a part. Do they now? Definitely don't know how so much about Nagato just by looking at this. So, what should we do? It's really difficult to look through all the titles. That doesn't mean we should ignore it, though.
Yep.
I'll leave it to you then, Hajime. Wait, what? It's better if a boy goes through another boy's things. You know, there might be private stuff here.
The porn.
Well, that might be true, but...
See?
So, I'll leave the shelf to you. I think I just got persuaded to do this without realizing it.
I've been bamboozled!
Sighed and walked toward the shelf. One by one, I started removing the various books and items and examined each one. Even as I examined them carefully, there were still a bunch of random books and items. There's no way there are any clues. Huh? Well, that file wasn't the only one I received from Monica. This is another one. That seal. Indeed, it's the school badge of Hope Speak Academy. Does that have information about our stolen memory? Unfortunately, I couldn't find any clues about that. This file doesn't contain our information. Hajime's information. I could have said it's only contained information about me, but... If I look at this, it should be obvious, right? And he said I was from the reserve department and no talent whatsoever. That might be another one of his lies, too. Open the file I held in my hand to confirm that. Instantly, I realized something was strange. He had ripped the pages out, didn't he? Or he took a black ink marker and wiped over it. This really has only my information. Why is the file so thick? Maybe there's a lot about you. Maybe you're just a bad boy. You're a bad egg. Watch me. As soon as I opened it up, it was clear to me, just as I thought, Nagato had lied to me. Aside from my information, there was information about others. Kazuichi, Fuyuhiko, Akane, Sonya. Everyone who died had pages of information about them, too. The file contained information of all 16. My information, my ass. I can't believe he made such a strange lie. That means that the rest of them might be a lie, too.
Wait. Will it be revealed that Chiaki is in fact the school infiltrator and or possibly traitor of the group? As he flips through the pages, Hajime, we may find that Chiaki is not in the book. Or the photo to Chiaki is somebody else. turned to the page containing my information and began reading through the content. Profile contained basic information such as my date, birth, height, weight, so forth, my breast size. Don't know why it's there.
I mean, I got man boobs, but they're called pectorals. Thank you very much.
Words reserve course student. No deny it, it confirmed that I truly was a reserve course student from the reserve department. Shit, I have no skills. Actually, info was only 2 pages. The rest of them are just Nagio writing Nada over and over again. See, nerd, I read that as hente for a second. Very different. Very different. Why is this the only thing that is in the line? Why am I the only one here who's from the reserve department? Why am I here with all the other ultimates? Was I the traitor all along? And I just got bonked on the head? My me being here, I'm inadvertently being the traitor? Hajime, something happened? Well, I just found a strange file.
Nani?
Isn't that the special prize Nagato received when he cleared the final dead room? As I recall, your student profile should be in here. It's not just my profile. Profiles of everyone on this island are here too. Nagato, lying.
Huh?
When you say everyone, do you mean everyone? Yeah, it's just basic information, but there should be profiles for all 16 of us. Can I take a look at that file?
No! Sweet Sever Child, don't do it!
Hajime is the generic NPC, yes. He's the guy that you come to and he's like, I have lost my chicken. Can you go find my chicken? Take 2 steps to the left, grab chicken. You have found my chicken. Here is a gold piece. You're a farmer, how do you have this? Bad developing. Okay, bye. Chiaki leaned against me and peered into the file.
You're right. My profile is really in here.
Wait. Oh, she...
But unfortunately, there doesn't seem to be any details.
Details?
Details about our missing memories. Information about the time we spent at Hope's Peak Academy.
Hashtag get Hajime's chicken 2020. Orbal is never going to get it back. He's not a chicken chaser. Yeah, you see, that's what you're there for. You gotta chase the chickens.
If it's not written in there, these profiles might have been written before we entered the academy.
Then it's impossible to obtain new clues from them.
Yeah, seems like it.
And it is so weird that a lot of the voice cast from Danganronpa 2 are in P4. And like, I mean, it's a great voice cast, don't get me wrong, but like, it definitely feels a little weird when you're like bouncing between games. Like, hold on.
Huh?
What happened? I just noticed it right now, but yeah, Johnny Bosch is the main character.
The file. His name isn't in there.
As
right?
Hajime here, and he's also the main character. All right, he's the voice character, like the guttural noises of the main character in P4, and he's also Akabari, Dojima's partner. God, I'm drawing a blank on his name.
There's supposed to be 16 names worth of profiles, but his name is the only one missing, right?
Who are you talking about?
Byakuya. I'm talking about Byakuya Togami.
Wait, Togami was the traitor? Huh. I still think it's Chiaki. I'm sorry, I still think it's
Chiaki. Look carefully. No matter where I look, I don't see his name anywhere.
No way!
So, what in a name? So, what if a name isn't written in that file? Perhaps, based on that, you think he might be the traitor.
No, it's not just because his name isn't written here. That's not the only reason I think he's suspicious. He participated in the killing school life at the Hope Seek Academy, right? For someone like him, be in a similar situation on this island? No matter what, it's definitely suspicious. Damn it!
Well, it pains me to say this, but what you're saying about the missing name and about the killing school life, well, it's just me. I'm sorry. I screwed up. I'm a bear of my name. A bear of my word.
Too bad.
It's totally wrong. There's completely different reason. A different reason?
You're getting all
How
riled up.
How should I put this? You guys have been getting all worked up about that Byakuya for no reason. Which means the great mystery that you think surrounds that Byakuya doesn't exist. Yay! Evening. You're basing it on one person's cheap speculation. What do you mean?
What the heck?
You don't have to ask me that. You know the answer just by looking through those profiles, right? Huh?
My eyes turned back to the file. One by one, I started flipping through the pages and confirming the names. Ultimate imposter? And suddenly, I came across a page that was filled with question marks. So, who? No data, but there's somebody that is the ultimate imposter. Completely forgot this game. Don't worry, we're near the end of the game, so we're good. Every section was filled with question marks. It could barely be considered a Steam profile. On that page, I was only able to confirm one. It's because he's yellow.
Ta-da!
If you wear a yellow suit, naturally you're suspect. Or a red suit. Or an orange suit. Or a blue suit. Black suit. Red suit. White suit. Basically, no matter what you're doing, you're suspect. I'm sorry. Sorry. I saw Byakuya event.
Get him! But that's...
That Byakuya's true identity. True identity. He was a fake that was a pretending to be the ultimate affluent progeny, Byakuya Togami.
A fake? Wait.
Hey,
The fact that his profile is filled with question marks isn't a mistake or an oversight. Surprisingly enough, that's the correct information regarding him. The ultimate imposter has no name, no permanent address, and even his age and gender is unknown.
Everyone votes for me. I don't even do anything wrong and I get voted. Even offline, I played with a few friends locally. I can't get past round one or two. And I have yet to be the actual imposter. I don't get it. I really don't get it. One of the reasons why I kind of stopped playing the game is just like, I can't get past anything. Sucks. Gonna try to play again? Probably down the road, but for right now, I think I'm kind of Among Us tapped out.
Basically, he doesn't exist. Because he doesn't exist, he's able to exist as anybody. That's his talent. Though I'm not jealous of that at all. That person wasn't really Byakuya Togami?
Perhaps.
Is that why he was so much fatter compared to when he was involved in the killing school life?
So cool!
His physique doesn't affect his ability to fool others at all. Real imposters are skilled like that. Yeah, but I'm a third imposter. Like, see, I just kind of assumed that he had a psychological, like, issue and he was eating his feelings and not coping properly between games. If he actually was a fake and Togami actually did live the original, then I'm going to feel a little bit better because, I mean, Togami was a dickhead of a dick. It's a super dick. But you know, he grew on you like a wart or moss growth. Eventually, you kind of like, you're okay. Then he was lying to us the whole time.
But still.
But he couldn't help it. What? Nani? Why couldn't he help it?
Oh.
Because his talent. Huh? Well, having talent means you're going also bound to that talent. The moment you attain talent, your way of life has already been chosen for you.
I can kind of see, like, somebody's like, hey, this guy's really good at this. And then you go to try anything else, they're always going to compare what you're good at to anything else you try. So there's a stigma to it. It's both a blessing and a curse, and it is how you perceive it and how you handle people around you.
You can't do anything else except rely on that talent, regardless of whether you want that life or not.
In that sense, compared to the other ultimates, your life might be a bit more liberating.
What the hell?
Anyway, I'm not happy that you guys fell for a scam that I had nothing to do with.
That's right!
So I'll tell you straight up, this revelation about Byakuya is exactly the truth.
Then, what was he trying to say to me at that time?
Not talk to others about my past. I suspect that my skeptical nature is partly to blame. Trusting others and being distrusted in turn. Long time my life has been a living hell.
Based on the context, I had to guess.
No!
Maybe he was just complaining that he was cursed to wander the earth as nothing more than a fraud. But if you guys had your school memories, you never would have been betrayed in the first place. I mean, it'd be different if you were meeting him for the first time.
Shing!
But since you guys went to Hope Speak Academy, you should have known about the ultimate imposter already.
So in the end, it all leads back to the memory loss?
Phew!
Jeez, Future Foundation sure is awful. There's no way you should ignore Madami or the traitor.
Who is it? Who's the traitor? Just from looking at these 16 pages, I still want to know who's from the Future Foundation. Is there really someone like that?
Of course!
Well, obviously you wouldn't know. I made the file so you guys couldn't find out.
Could it be?
So it's just as I thought. You're the one who did it.
Hey!
The fact that there are 16 profiles in there is what's wrong. I mean, the traitor is a spy sent by the Future Foundation, not a student from Hope Speak Academy.
You made a fake profile for the traitor and included it in here?
Correct!
It wouldn't be fun if you figured out who the traitor was so easily, right?
Hey.
Then we can't use this file to figure out who the traitor is. That was the true for Nagato too, right?
Well, probably. He was a bit sharper than most of you, to be really fair. You know what? Never mind. Later.
Well, the more I think about it, the more it feels like Terra did a vent kill on Ultimate Investor.
Yes! Actually, you are right!
Poor Terra, I haven't thought about that man in a long time and his feisty, thirsty, fiery hunger for the ladies.
It's stripping with despair, isn't it? You wasted your precious time on something that isn't...
Are you sure about this?
Was there a wise decision? Time's up, you know. Wait.
Bye-bye!
Excuse me for a moment.
Damn it. Time to go into a trial and final chapter. Let's go.
That chime just now.
Ah, crap.
What is most important for living things?
To not be a robot.
Well, personally, I think time is. I mean, your bank account may go up and down, but time will inevitably run out, right? That's why we gotta cherish time. There is nothing more wasteful than wasting time. So... time's up! We will begin the last class trial! So please gather at Monokuma Rock!
Maybe they even actually mentioned that it's the last one. I don't want to think about Teruto any more than the bare minimum. Kinda odd, that is his bare minimum.
I'll see you soon!
Okay!
Last class trial? He said that, right? He said last class trial.
Yep.
Yeah, heard it too. He really did say it was the last class trial. What do you think? Believe him?
Monokuma.
I'm anxious about the Monokuma timer. More days. Something about the killing school trip ended. Based on the time limit, might definitely be the last one.
But still.
But I can't imagine that it's the real end. Huh? I think Monokuma's real plan might be just beyond that. Real plan? Is Monokuma still trying to plan, still planning to make us do something? What could it be? Maybe after putting us through all of this, he's planning to kill the remaining survivors all at once?
Well?
But still, it's also not a good idea to think about it too much. Think. Think. Focus on the class trial that's waiting first. You're right.
Class trial for Nagato's murder. We're pretty screwed. That's it. Game over, chat. Pack your bags. This is a great game. Pretty decent. Ending was a little kiddy-wampus. I thought we'd have something a little more fuller, but apparently we're screwed. So, naturally, we can't keep playing. That's right, right. Okay, so, guess we just switch it over to Persona, or...
I haven't collected any thoughts because we were so focused on this file. I can't see who killed Nagato.
But still...
You don't have to worry so much. Huh?
Right?
I mean, not fighting this alone, you know.
You're right. You're absolutely right. We're not alone. Even if it's a mystery that can't be solved alone, as long as everyone cooperates and works together.
By the power of friendship, we will succeed. And cherish our moments together,
even if they're final moments.
Yeah, if we do that, it'll turn out fine.
Or not. Not being a pessimist here, I'm being relatable. Whoa! Nani? Hold on. What was the button that allowed me to go into the, not escape? Ah, crap, I forgot the... Ah, F1. There we go. Picking our pet here. Pet's doing good. Does, anyone remember where we have to go? There was a fast travel, wasn't there? Ah, there it is. Monokuma was Mountain. Right. Most relatable character. Hajime, the everyman. The innocent summer child. Nagato was the asshole who was more willing to work with the bad guys than the good guys. Because, oh! He was also the one that looked vaguely similar to the hero from the first game. And our main character.
Damn right.
Looks like everyone's here.
Huh?
Huh? Hey, this is it? Shouldn't there be more people?
Damn it.
Stop it. You're making me depressed.
Stupid fool.
You're making me depressed.
Hang on.
You're making me depressed.
I don't know if that sounded like a robot.